Commander. Carl's shift starts in 5 hours.
Anything else?
No, doesn't.
What can I do for you? Karen's not around, and this line is secure. What can I do for you?
You don't know how happy I am to hear that. At this point, I would if I could. But Val keeps me in the dark about some things. Plausible deniability and all that. Ask her.
What can I do for you? Tell me. What can I do for you? Yes. What can I do for you?
Not right now.
Thank you.
What can I do for you? Tell me.
Commander. Not right now. Maybe Carl has something. Commander. Yes, make it quick.
Construction complete.
If it isn't my old mate, safe and sound on Titan. Didn't think we'd see each other again so soon, yeah? Heard about the crash. Kamigatsa. Good to see you're okay. Nah, it must stink being down there drinking with the flies. Hell, not even flies, I reckon. Sorry about that, mate. We're trying to come up with something, but we don't have any more crew-capable landers on board. That's classified. Can't say. Alright, we're here as a contingency plan. Help you out if you're in trouble. Yeah, so, what do you need? Sure did. I've got a budget for consignment and exactly one drop pod limited by weight. But half a loaf is better than none, yeah? Yeah, alright. I'll get it sent down immediately. The landing has been tagged on the west side of the space elevator platform. Go check it out when you're ready. Let's hope we hit the mark. G'day, mate. Sing it. Yeah. All right. Yeah, so. Yeah, nah, that.
What can I do for you?
Ah, we have a connection. Pleased to meet you, Commander. Allow me to introduce myself. Rutger Van Horn. Your new best friend and junior vice president of Van Hoor Logistics. Straight to the point. Good, we don't have much time. You government types wouldn't know, but there's a whole world outside the scope of your utilitarian missions and Spartan spacecraft. You don't need to be crammed up inside some tin can like you were. No, you can live in relative comfort even in space. If you got the cash. Ah, but see. That's where you're wrong. I happen to know a little bit about your mission's budget, and boy, did they cut corners. Look, you may not be comfortable now. You may have taken this job out of desperation, idealism, or even greed. Nah, they don't pay you enough for that. But I digress. What I mean is, there's no reason you shouldn't be comfortable in the future. Here's the deal. During the next shipment, you siphon away some of your methane for us, and we pay you a king's ransom in Wuchu. How does that sound? Don't worry, This is a secure channel, while it lasts. Ha! Who do you think got the contract for shipping the methane to Earth? We did. We're working for the same people. On paper. All I need you to do is keep some of that hydrocarbon goodness off the book so we can, divert those resources. Hell no! What do you think happens when the ISA monopolizes this resource? Do you think we'd still be getting contracts? They would use that leverage to bleed Van Horn dry, and every other private enterprise with it. We would be completely dependent on the Chinese or slowly be assimilated into the ISA. There are people who think humanity will be the better for it, but if you ask me, that kind of power in the hands of one institution is the stuff of nightmares. Pragmatism. A good trait in the business. Doing well is precisely what I'm about. Make sure you reserve some methane for us. You won't regret it. We provide supply chain solutions in the solar system, but at heart, we're still the family company. Our unique concept is based on what our customers want. The best quality, proven designs, short delivery times, low maintenance, and excellent value. Sorry, we were being eavesdropped. I managed to reseed our encryption, but this channel won't be secure for long. I'll make it quick. The freighters are ours, so filling them to capacity is not the problem. Bookkeeping is. Every drop you send up is registered and transmitted to mission control. You need to circumvent that system. How do you do that is up to you, as long as you keep it on the down low. We'll start with 10 tons. I'm sad to hear that. Maybe we can do business at a later stage.
G'day, mate. Sing it.
What can I do for you? Yes?
Construction complete.
Commander. Carl's shift starts in 9 hours. He's probably... Anything else? Yes.
What can I do for you?
Good job. Let me check.
I've got... Let's see. It's a Finnish name. Koitalakus on the list. It's mid-sized, relatively close, not very remarkable. Koiteri? Whatever. Check it out.
Research complete.
What can I do for you?
Nope. Nothing we can do for you from up here, I'm afraid. If you can't do it...
Hello, Commander. You are out of range for Yeti AM-1 to conduct repairs. That is outside of the parameters of my problem-solving routines. I couldn't have come up with that. It could work. It works. I will make the adjustment. Yeti AM-1 will be there in 5 hours. Hello, Commander. Which one? You must be in the command center to access the logistical map.
First citizen of Titan. Have you found any titanium yet? No? Silly joke. I'm sorry. Let me introduce myself. My name is Horst. I work on a research vessel orbiting Enceladus. What about that? Of course they know that. We were just visited by the Hesiod. I suppose you were just left in ignorance. We provide them occasional support. And in return, they value our privacy. We would very much like to work directly with you. Of course. We are not affiliated with the IASA or the transatlantic government. Herschel is an independent German company and our headquarters are right outside Kourou Spaceport. Technically, Germany doesn't exist anymore, but many people still identify as such. I know, I do. I guess Europe has never been the melting pot that United States was. For language and culture to mix, you really do have to uproot people, you know? My family has lived in Germany for so long that it doesn't matter what government they get to vote for. We'll always be German. Fair enough, We are funded by a group of wealthy European citizens who used to dominate the automotive industry. They wanted more of a focus on scientific missions. We are all the same, but you do enjoy the occasional slur? I do not mind rudeness, but I can't stand for inconsistency. Pick a side. Wasser under the bridge, as they say. Of course. Because implants can't keep up with technology. I can change your circuitry and these things every month if I want to. I can't get a new implant every year. I need to be on the cutting edge. Besides, they look geil. Good pun. Of course. What we want is to utilize Titan's true potential. Hydrocarbon use will soon be a thing of the past. Titan's true potential is thermal regulation. Imagine an atmosphere that can dissipate over 30 trillion watts of heat. We can run a practically infinite amount of hypercooled semiconductors for supercomputers. Fusion power. It's just around the corner. It doesn't matter if you believe me or not. Let's just say I'm in the position to know. So, what I need you to do first is deploy a Herschel nexus on the surface of Titan. We will ship it to Titan from here. It will arrive in 3 days. It is almost fully autonomous, but will require some manual work to deploy. Is contributing in science not enough? Don't worry. You will be compensated with resources in WCU. We will include some useful assets in the nexus module. 10 kilos of high-grade plutonium. That is all we can physically ship with the module. Trust me, this endeavor will be worth your while. Very good, contact me when the Nexus has landed and we will discuss how to proceed.
Commander. Yes.
The Nexus has landed. Have you found it yet? That's just a shell. Let's get ready to deploy it. Please link your suit to the comms panel. I'll program the transponder code for you. I assure you, it's perfectly safe. Well, you know how to contact me, if you do change your mind. Of course. Yes, but we're not a charity. What do you need? Of course. Yes, there is a location called the Minerva crater near the outpost that shows heavier elements on our deep spectrum analysis. Check your log. Changed your mind about the transponder? Of course. It's a dense, pliable polymer that stiffens under high pressure differentials. It's not very useful on Titan, I'm afraid. But you can easily process the shell for use by your construction system. Of course. Changed your mind about the transponder? Done. Just go outside and deploy the Nexus. Get back to me when it's done. And don't forget to pick up the present we left for you inside. You've done it. Isn't it magnificent? Now it's time to start building nodes in the outpost. It's quite a power draw, so you'll need to get a little more juice flowing through your base before we can set things up. You can put that plutonium into good use. Don't worry. All in due time. Take your time to increase the generator's capacity. I'm just so excited. We might even be able to break the zettaflop barrier. Zettaflop. A sextillion calculations per second. It's the next milestone in computation. Jedenfalls, a node draws about 2000 watts of power. It will also provide about 1500 watts worth of heat to your base, so you will be able to convert more thermal energy from your generator. Good. We will compensate you with 0.00016 WCU per exaflop. One node will yield about 100 exaflops. That's roughly 100 WCU per week. If you build 10 hyper-cooled computer rooms, we'll make history. We'll finally make a dent in all the queued up research and more. Please contact me when you get a node up.
Wie geil, wie geil.
You're right. I've adjusted the price.
Construction complete.
Commander, not right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
What can I do for you? Do you need help building the first computer room? I'll tell you what. You build that first computer and power it up. If you tried improving the efficiency of your reactor, I can share our latest research on thermoelectrics with you. I'll tell you what. You build that first computer and power it up, and I'll share the research with you.
What can I do for you? Not right now. Yes?
I see you didn't manage to keep any of the methane off the books. That's unfortunate. I hope our future transactions will be more successful. As a sign of good faith, I'll still send you a little care package. Just realize it could have been more. A lot more. Pleasure doing business with you. Orbital drop. It's on the way as we speak. Nothing that wasteful, surely. Let me worry about the how. Don't forget, I know a thing or two about logistics.
Research complete. Thank you. Construction complete. Construction complete. Thank you.
What can I do for you?
Good job. Let me check.
Satanera Locus is up next. Sotonera? Spanish. It's slightly deeper than most, and there's more atmospheric pressure due to a permanent weather feature on the north end. If my readings are correct, a pump would be able to fill two tanks simultaneously at this lake. Data uploaded.
Thank you.
Construction complete. Construction complete.
Thank you. Thank you.
What can I do for you? Not right.
What can I do for you? Do you need help building the first computer room?
Search complete. Hello, Commander. What is it you need?
Thank you.
Construction complete. Search complete.
Thank you.
Commander. Not right now.
Thank you.
Construction complete.
Hi, what can I do for you? Pleasure doing business with you.
Hello, Commander.
Thank you.
Of course. The Shani is essentially a mining, research and industrial vessel all in one. Our mission is to consolidate a position for Talt in the Saturnian system.
Oh, I suppose we have an interest in hydrocarbons like everybody else. And I'm happy to be off the Shani, to be honest. Our ship is unfinished. We are still trying to make parts of the second ring operational, but we left in a hurry when we found out about your mission. It's very cramped and tensions are running high. Despite Ekta's effort, it is especially taxing on us women. Of course. I'm fine, thank you. Hello, Commander. Of course. She's my boss. She's courageous, resourceful, and kind. I try to be more like her. Yes. Of course. I'm fine, thank you. Hello, Commander. Of course. Put it on the roster and I will get to it.
Construction complete.
The lander was launched with velocity from our own approach vector yesterday. Jade has landed and will use the access code you provided to enter the outpost. What can I do for you? TALT is humanity's leading industrial conglomerate and we are its Saturnian resource mining operation. The Shani is still unfinished, but we decided to continue construction in transit when we learned of your mission. This is the new frontier, and we can't afford to let this endeavor slip past us. TALT needs hydrocarbons like everybody else. I'm an heir to the throne, so to speak, but as my father's seventh child, the odds of ever inheriting control over the company are not in my favor. I'm forging my own path on new frontiers. What can I do for you? We can't spare anyone else. What can I do for you? What can I do for you?
What can I do for you? Do you need search around and process some old stuff? I know a place near the outpost that should be rich in minerals. We need it surveyed anyway. I'll tell you what.
Hi, what can I do for you? Unless you're doing business.
Research complete. Construction complete.
Hello, Commander. Of course, of course. Sure, why not? That was fun.
Research complete. Construction complete. Construction complete.
What is it? I told you I'd let you know when I'm ready to say more. Wait until the fourth methane shipment has arrived. I'll probably be ready by then.
Research complete. Construction complete.
Hello, Commander.
Commander, the polar imaging satellite deorbited. I have no visuals on the surface, but it seems to have crashed somewhere in the Poratrine Plains. Find it and report back to me. We don't know. Carl says it's a command interface error and the booster accidentally went off. I think it's sabotage. I suspect it's the Jinx. We lose, they win. That's just the way it is. It won't be easy. The terrain there is relatively flat, so you might be able to spot it from a distance. But the Poratrine Planitia is almost 2,000 kilometers across. Good luck.
Search complete.